Hey guys, in this video, we're going to show you the new and exciting developments featured in the QuickShow 3.0 software. Here, you can see the QuickShow 3.0 user interface. All of the popular features of QuickShow are still implemented in the new update. So the easy-to-use workspace, queue grid, and live control panel are all still featured. You also have the popular Quick tools, such as Quick Text, Quick Shape, Quick Trace, Quick Targets, Quick DMX, the timeline, quick capture, and quick effects, all easily accessible. And the convenient frame editor and drawing programs are also implemented with the new update. If you are not already familiar with the QuickShow user interface, please check out our previous tutorial videos showing how to use and work with the software. You can access these in the software by going to the help file, and we also have more videos available on our YouTube channel, and you can find these using the link below. In QuickShow 3.0, we've implemented some awesome new MIDI support features, as well as a custom map for the popular APC Mini, which you can see here. These features are great for clients running live laser shows, or for those who prefer the touch and feel a console has to offer. To use the APC Mini with QuickShow, simply connect the device to your PC via USB, and the APC Mini map we created will automatically load once you open QuickShow. You will notice the nice pangolin text scrolling across the unit, as you just saw. The connection is fast and easy and truly plug and play. No complex programming is required. To begin, we're going to set the queue grid in QuickShow to perfectly match the grid on the APC Mini. This way, you have an 8x8 configuration in the QuickShow workspace matching the 8x8 grid on the APC Mini. Once this is done, you can simply press the buttons in the APC Mini grid and instantly see the content displayed in laser, as you see here. You can also see the queues changing in QuickShow software as you move from one queue to the next. The APC Mini map also allows you to toggle back and forth through different pages of queues to access the different type of laser content you may need at any given time. QuickShow can also be set to display a message telling you what features are being executed from the APC Mini. You can do this by going to Settings and then Configuration, as you see here. Then, anytime you trigger something from the APC Mini, QuickShow will display a message telling you what is taking place. Next, let's review what the effect sliders on the bottom of the APC Mini do. Starting from left to right, these control brightness, colors, rotation X, rotation Y, and rotation Z, size on your XY axis, visible points, scan speed, and animation speed. On the right-hand side of the APC Mini, you will notice a series of 8 circular buttons and 1 square button. Let's review what each of these buttons does individually. Moving from top to bottom, your first button is for blackout. The second button is used to enable and disable laser output, and you'll notice that when it is enabled, it flashes green. The third button is used to move to the next page of QuickShow queues, and the fourth button allows you to go back to the previous page of queues. The fifth button is for reset of rotation, the sixth button is for reset of live control settings, the seventh button is used for changing your live control focus from master to queue. This will also be green if it is in master. The eighth button is used for BPM control. The square button is a shift button, and this brings up some additional control options. When shift is enabled, your top 4 lines of the APC Mini can be used for effects. And the circular buttons on the right allow you to pause, move to the next or previous category, control your virtual laser jockey toggle, and reset your BPM to 120. You can find a convenient map, also listing all of the features available on the APC Mini on our website. In the middle of the APC Mini, you will also notice a horizontal series of 8 circular buttons. These control your zones in QuickShow software. You'll notice that as we trigger the buttons from the APC Mini, we can project or mute the different zones we have set up in the QuickShow software. This makes it really easy to control multiple laser projectors or to create multiple zones for a single laser projector. Everyone wants to sync music and lasers together, and we've now taken BPM control to a whole other level with our Virtual DJ plugin and Quickshow 3.0. Here you can see Virtual DJ running together with Quickshow. Our new plugin is called Laser Beat, and it shows up in the list of Virtual DJ effect plugins. To begin, we're going to load up some music into Virtual DJ and then activate Laser Beat by clicking the icon. What's really cool is that as we play the music in Virtual DJ, it's sending that beat information to Quickshow in real time. Notice how the BPM in Virtual DJ exactly matches the BPM in Quickshow. And as the music speeds up or slows down, you can see that it does this in Quickshow also. So as we trigger cues in Quickshow, they are precisely synced to the beat of the music in Virtual DJ, making it really easy to time your lasers and music together. What's also really cool is that if we grab the track wheel in Virtual DJ, we can speed up or slow down the laser content and it will still exactly match the beat of the music. But that's not the only thing we can do. Check this out. Let's bring up a static image in Quickshow like a circle and then apply an effect to it. Let's say an oscillating zoom. Using the plugin, we can tell Quickshow to pick up the BPM information from Virtual DJ, and now the effect we applied will follow the BPM and sound from Virtual DJ. So we can make a cool little speaker like the one you see here and have it go exactly to the beat of the music in Virtual DJ. In this example, we had Virtual DJ and Quickshow running on the same PC, but you can also run them from separate PCs if you want and link them together using a network cable. We've also got plugins in development for other DJ programs like Serato and Traktor coming soon, so be sure to stay tuned. The Pangolin Cloud is an innovative new feature in Pangolin software that provides you with a seemingly unlimited source of fresh laser content. To access the Pangolin Cloud, just click on the cloud icon in the upper left-hand corner of the software. Then, log in using your username and password, and you can access the Pangolin Cloud as you see here. Once you're inside the cloud, you can browse a wide variety of laser content and then simply drag and drop that content into your Quickshow workspace to use for future events. Another nice feature of the Pangolin Cloud is that it provides a platform for artists to create, share, and sell content with others in the Pangolin community. You can also create your own profile in the Pangolin Cloud just like you would in Facebook to share your content from. As you can see, we're designing a simple abstract animation. Once the animation is designed, we're going to define a name for that content and description for it and publish it to the Pangolin Cloud. Once the content is published, it will be available inside of your Pangolin Cloud profile for others to download and use. More features and functions are being added to the cloud, and additional videos showing this platform will be coming soon. This concludes our introduction to the Quickshow 3.0 software. We hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you have any further questions about Quickshow, please feel free to contact us at any time. We're always happy to help.